And it comes under 3 minutes after the Rangers took their first lead. Now we've got a fight. And Buchnevich is getting worked over just inside the blue line. Is that Chase on? Oh, it's Versteeg, pardon me. Kris Versteeg not happy with Pavel Buchnevich and landed a couple of good right hands before that went to the ice.
And Versteeg came up throwing bombs. And he's not a real big guy, just 179 pounds. 5'10", but a lot of fury behind those blows. He was mean in business. And I'm not quite sure what ticked him off to begin with, Rick, but he was awfully upset with Buchnevich. And take a look off the faceoff. And right away they come together. Versteeg with the quick whack, and Buchnevich gives him a little cross check. And both players willing combatants, but looks like Versteeg might have been doing a little boxing over the summer. Quick rights, and then
pretty good.
Buchnevich just loses balance and goes down to the ice.
Well, interesting to see how they call this one. It looks like it was mutual. I don't think we'll see an instigator out of that scrap.
I'd be very surprised. Both players seem to drop their gloves instantaneously.
But the bad news is, because the jersey came off and wasn't tied down, Versteeg is kicked out of the game. And he's had a pretty good night, or afternoon, pardon me.
Yeah, lots of time left in this game. Over 15 minutes, so that's a pretty important player. He's waving to the faithful here at MSG as he makes his exit. And there's the sweater. Comes right off of Versteeg, so not tied down. And unfortunate circumstances here for the Calgary Flames and Kris Versteeg as he quickly slips the jersey back on and have a little fun here with the crowd.
Yeah, like Broadway, a little curtain call.
At least he gave just the nice little wave, because I've seen some players give some other kind of gestures to the fans, and that never turns out well for the players, because you can't get away with anything these days with instant replays.